do that and then have expect a full composite report on the whole issue of dog travel. And, you know, let's see if the people of Wirral, which I believe, you know, the good intention of most people is that they don't allow their dogs anyway at the moment to go uncontrolled without a lead in cemeteries. They don't allow their dogs to foul in the places where the children are, but at least then we put a sign up. That would be all very nice, but it's not backed up by a piece of PSPO because we need to have a full composite report on the way forward on this, otherwise we're all laughing stock as far as I'm concerned.
Mike, you know, Cam wants to come up with you. Did you want to come in as well?
Just to say that the idea is that the PSPO will be incremental and will be enforced. As we've already given assurances, any future measures will come back to this committee for consideration, obviously including dog fouling. Just to be clear, the signage is purely for play areas and cemeteries, and that is antisocial behaviour in both those types of facilities. I can assure you that we have that on record.
Yeah, is that possible? As you said, no, I think we'd like to say we'll raise an advisory and the 20-mile-an-hour standard advisory. There's no laws of that sort.
I think in relation, the current position is that there are some cemeteries that make it clear that you cannot take a dog into those cemeteries. It's not necessarily a good option to then assist the public by actually breaching that bylaw by allowing dogs to be in a cemetery on their own. So I think those are signed to allow for that. There is some case for that. So I think again, we just need to think that process through and perhaps we might come back with the report that you're talking about to incorporate the issue of enforcement. Because the purpose of the PSPO really is to enforce. And I think that's an issue which currently Mike is obviously is looking at and is considering, but we need to look at that as part of the package. So, and that might incorporate the issue of science as well. Okay, go on, Terry.
Just for information, are these sites covered by CCTV cameras? And how do we liaise with the ordinary police forces on this?
I'm not sure the total amount of CCTV coverage we could find. I thought that some of it may be covered by not all of it. And obviously the police have no jurisdiction on enforcing our laws. It's our service for us to find out.
Just my final one, Andy. George will back me up on this because he was a meeting with me last week. We've done an inclusion zone around open air dog licensing, no street drinking. We put signs up everywhere, but we enforce it, and that's the difference. And Jean Stapleton, who's the head councillor, has confirmed that the problem is coming down because we've got the signage up, but we're enforcing it, and that's what we've got to do.
Okay. On these recommendations, there's some suggestions from our both sides that they wanted to maybe add a recommendation or two. Or is everyone happy for those recommendations?
Can I just suggest a way forward, because I think everybody is in agreement that we should have signage put up there. The issue seems to be whether or not we should have PSPOs or bylaws to actually enforce that. We've all admitted that we cannot enforce it, so there seems no point at all in putting forward the PSPO in this particular. I would recommend that we put signage up in cemeteries to ensure that dogs be under control and by use of a lead, and that the play areas, multi-use games, mothers, kickabouts, dogs prohibited from entry and subject to conditions including concessions for working assistant and therapy dogs. Is everybody happy with that? Without the implementation of a PCSO. Rambling a little bit, but I'm just
bylaws, because I think what we're asking for is to go against our own bylaws.
That's the issue that I think I'm trying to raise early in relation to Councillor Rennie, and that brought this matter up. There are some cemeteries that say no dogs are allowed in that particular cemetery. To encourage users to go in those particular cemeteries, which is why I think there was a reference to the change, either the bylaw or bylaw of PSPO, to accommodate the dogs to be under control by them to get over the issue of no dogs being allowed whatsoever. It is, I think, the thinking behind Mike's reasoning for a PSPO change. I think at the moment you're looking at a recommendation and a comment. Clearly, in some cemeteries where there is a provision to prevent dogs going in, an encouragement for users to go in with on a lead would be going against your own guidelines. So I think we need to look at those, and maybe some cemeteries that would allow it, and maybe some cemeteries that we would have to look to amend that bylaw, revoke that bylaw, and then if you wanted to have conditions on one cemetery, that's where the PSP would come.
So just to confirm, it's possible to remove both man-made bylaws?
Well, there would have to be a process to go through to amend, and I think because of the dog control issue, and under 2005, we're not looking at this new bylaws, it would have to be via PSPO in relation to controlling the dog within those cemeteries.
Can I just clarify, sorry, Chair, that it would appear, the group of wrong that we would have to caution the bylaw. We can't put signs, we'd have to get rid of the bylaw. That's correct, isn't it? Or obviously this, yeah?
Yes. To take that provision out to prevent people going in the cemetery with a dog. So, dogs not allowed in your cemeteries, it's currently in place, and we're going to take that out of the equation, because it's going to go for bylaws, or make the case clear, which allows
Thank you, Chair. Don't want to drag this out too long, but I wonder if we could perhaps take the two aspects separately. I think the situation of the cemeteries with players are different, and I think we could probably reach agreement certainly on the cemetery, is because we're actually relaxing present situation if we were to go through PSPO recommendation there. On the play areas, clearly there's a division of opinion in the committee, and I wonder if we could agree this in principle, subject to another report on how enforcement is going to be carried out, because I think we all agree that we want it stopping, the point is rightly made that a sign is probably not going to be sufficient. So if we come back with a further report on exactly how we're going to implement enforcement, we might be able to agree that as well. But so I think in the present circumstances, maybe it's premature to proceed with that PSP. So I'm suggesting we take the two items separately as slightly different solutions.
Just a clarification, please. Also from Ken, he used to make the point the last when he summed up there that you're not allowed in cemeteries dogs.
There may be some bylaws that actually relate to certain cemeteries that prevent dogs going into those cemeteries.
Okay, well I can accept what
that would be an offence.
The point I'm making is Flavig Cemetery, which is the one by me, yeah. That everyone uses that cemetery to walk through to go to Liston Hill, walking the dogs, every single person. So there's no restriction whatsoever for the cemetery.
I can't be clear whether that's one of the cemeteries relating to where no dogs are supposed to be entering, but if that's the case, then that's where the enforcement issue needs to be.
Okay. Allan, do you want to put those words into a recommendation and just a word?
I propose that we accept the recommendation of the PSPO to allow dogs in cemeteries on the lead.
Yeah.
That we support the PSPO proposal in play areas, etc., in principle, subject to a further report on how that will be enforced.
we've got one extra bit on that, that we actually go back to the user groups, particularly have a wider consultation on this, because clearly, I know some of us perhaps haven't had their inboxes pretty full with it, but I certainly haven't, and all the members of the bar group have. So there are clearly just people out there who feel that we haven't consulted with them properly, and we need to take note of that and incorporate further consultation with the dog user groups to formulate that next report, which is about.
I'll stay there. Okay, so we've got samples of that, so. It was Allan's original. If you were to accept that, so just let's clarify. Yes, you are. So in cemeteries, in cemeteries to accept, subject to consultation with user groups. In play areas, we accept in principle, but to come back to a further committee, we will have been to enforce it subject to consultation.
Just to let members away from the consultation issue, and obviously the appeal, is proposed, that would then trigger off a certain number of statutory requirements, including consultation.
Anything else from anybody? Great. Well, we'll close the meeting and stay there.